So guys, today I'm going to organize and clean up my fresh and clean tray. Honestly, when I'm done, it's probably gonna look exactly like it does right now. This is a tray that I leave out year round. And these are the perfumes that I use for bedtime or for going to the gym, which is my gym, which is going on the treadmill. Anything where I need to feel just fresh, clean, nothing too heavy, nothing strong, nothing too sweet, nothing vanillic. I'm sure there's vanilla notes in some of these perfumes, but you know what I mean. Like, these are just my light, easygoing, easy reaches, and I could wear any of these if I'm going like out somewhere that I don't want to smell like too strong. I don't want to offend anyone, even if there's someone who may have like allergies to perfume. A lot of these are clean brands that I could use for an occasion like that. So I'm just gonna clean these up as I go. I'm going to dust everything and wipe it up. So starting out with Pearl from Element Edition. It's really just a very soapy, clean, and fresh scent. It smells almost like bubble bath from when you were a kid. Like I'm having a bubble bath and the bubbles are popping right under my nose. This was $16.99 at Winners. You can find it probably at TJ Maxx if you're in the US. This is a real find. I'm really glad that I got this one. As I go through these, I'm going to be looking for any that maybe I would declutter, but this is definitely going to be a keeper. Next, we have this classic little baby, Lake and Sky 1111. And this, I always call it a crisp white amber. It's very crisp, it's very laundry fresh. It would remind you of just clean sheets. It's not metallic smelling, but very clean, a steely clean. It really does smell very angelic, very cloud-like, light, like a high-pitched cleanness, if that makes sense. But it's not astringent and it's not like clinical or anything like that. It doesn't smell like a cleaner to me. It's just the happiest, brightest, freshest clean scent you ever did smell. I love to wear this to go on the treadmill, especially, and yeah, and to bed. That's gonna be a common theme on this tray. Carolina Herrera 212. This one leans a little bit more floral, but it is a fresh, clean, white floral. This is an oldie and a cheapie, but a goodie. Well, I have a couple by the brand Clean here, and this is from their classic line. This one, Fresh Linens, it always reminds me of like a lemon laundry detergent. The only thing is, I believe it has either mandarin or clementine in it, or tangerine. It does not have lemon, but it has that lemony fresh smell. Almost a little bit of a neroli smell. You know how sometimes a lemon laundry detergent will have that neroli vibe to it? But it also has like a warmth to it, very like rounded edges to it. It's not sharp, it's not harsh, it's not really detergent-like, but it would remind you of that. This is a really nice one even to spray on your sheets. So this is a great bedtime one. Yeah, love this. And her little brother, Soft Laundry. Look at the spire on this. Isn't that nice? I mean, this was, I don't know, my gosh. Probably this was under $20, I think. And this does have the laundry vibe. It's called Soft Laundry, but it smells like after your clothes come out of the dryer and they have that really cozy, comforting scent. It does have a little bit of like the blue fabric softener smell, but just a hint. Whereas Cool Cotton and Warm Cotton to me almost smell too realistically like sticking your nose into a bottle of Danny April Fresh or something like that. This doesn't have that intensity. It gives you like a cozy, happy, like I just put on my favorite sweatshirt out of the laundry feeling. This is Glossier You. You'll notice that the red cap is missing. I don't feel like red fits with the vibe of my tray. So this is destined to just be capless, but that's okay. I do have the cap. We all know and love Glossier You. No, not everybody loves it. I've heard people say that it smells like a damp dish rag. To me, it is such a beautiful, powdery skin scent. It has pepper, it has iris. This is always going to be one of my favorites because it's just so cozy, so powdery. It's a beautiful skin scent. This feels like a warm hug, but I would wear it out anywhere and it would be totally non-offensive. It would make everyone think that you are the cozy, huggable auntie of life. Gucci Bamboo, I just spoke about in my underrated gems video. Oh my word. Talk about, if you're talking about this scent category, imagine the creamiest one, the warmest one, the most woody, but not dry woody, not smoky woody, but like a creamy wood, creamy woods. It has the most soft and pretty sandalwood in it you could ever imagine. This is, now I've actually read a few reviews on this lately, and a lot of people are calling it like date night worthy. A lot of people are saying that it is a fall and winter scent. They're seeing that warmth in it, and I believe it has vanilla in it as well. But it is still a soapy clean fragrance to me, but like in the best way possible. This is underrated. It's just a treasure. Look at my dent. This is, yeah, I love this. I never want to be without Gucci Bamboo. This is the EDP. Should I talk about her now? Should I, guys? Should I? I mean, I don't talk about this little girl enough. Jo Malone Wood Sage and Sea Salt. Now I have quite a good dent on this one as well. Yeah, you guys probably know it. You probably have smelled it. It is your fresh, salty, a beach, but you know, a cold beach on the coast of Ireland where the salt spray is just spraying up off the rocks and the waves are crashing. Driftwood, like not tropical sunscreen beachy. This is cold northern beach beachy, but oh my word. I mean, this is one of my favorites of all time. I have the body lotion as well. I wear this on the treadmill almost exclusively. I don't usually wear this one to bed. I wear this on the treadmill because it gives me the biggest boost of energy. It gives me a mood boost. As if going on the treadmill wasn't enough of a mood boost. I love going on the treadmill. I love breaking into a run when the chorus of the song hits. Yeah, so I don't know what to say about this except I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. Now, this one is one of the ones I am most excited to wear this spring. This is Narciso Eau de Parfum Cristal. This is a very pretty sweet floral with the Narciso musk DNA. So it definitely has the same musky powderiness that the other Narciso cubes have, but this is the lighter, fresher version. This is like the girly pink version. It's very pretty, very floral, a little bit sweet, like a little bit fruity sweet, but it still is cozy. You could wear this on an evening out. I sometimes do wear this to bed, not as much for working out, but yeah, this is a beauty. So I don't have my Chance Eau Tendre perfume out yet. It's still in my drawers. I haven't gotten it out for spring yet, but this is the hair mist. And I do use this quite often, and I actually do use it in my hair. And it just goes along with all of these scents so well. And that's why there's such a big dent in it, because it honestly goes so perfectly with like with this entire collection, everything I've shown you. In my opinion, this is the perfect layering accessory for all of this entire scent category. Versace Vanitas. Guys, this has been a favorite of mine for a while. This is kind of a little bit of a beachy tropical floral, but in the lightest, freshest way possible. It has lime in it, so it's very uplifting, very bright. It has the worst cap in the world to get off. I'm serious. Like, it's really, it's really a struggle. Oh my word. Oh, I really get the freshness and the brightness and the citrusiness from this. Now, there is just showing you how hard the cap is to get on and off. This would never offend anybody. You could wear this all spring, all summer, and honestly, I want to wear this to bed sometime soon. And sometimes when I wear a scent like this to bed, I just start to fall in love with it more and more and appreciate it more and more. This is the EDP Versace Vanitas. Okay, guys, don't make fun of me. I mean, I know that this is like an ultra cheapy at Winners and Marshalls and places like that. This would almost remind you a little bit of Cerruti 1881, and I know it's called Guess 1981, but it does have that little bit of a chamomile tea feeling to it. This is one of my favorites to spray my bed with, to spray my sheets with. I use this more as a linen spray just because it does not last on skin. If you've ever tried it, you probably know that it's not very strong, but it is very pretty. It reminds me of like a light pink chamomile tea, sort of. Yeah, this gives me a very happy feeling. I definitely would wear this on the treadmill. If you want to learn to love the treadmill, let me know and I will help you because I do love it. And this is a great one for that. So another very affordable one is Hollister Wave. This probably is actually one of the sweetest ones on my tray. This is kind of like the leisure version of something like Juicy Couture. So it does have that fruity floral feel, but it is a lighter, fresher, more easy wear, easy reach fragrance. And I haven't worn it that much. Honestly, I want to wear this one more because it's actually really pretty and kind of underrated. So Bulgari Omnia Crystalline. This is the EDT. I do have a sample of the EDP. It is out of production. It's discontinued, but you can see kind of how much there actually is a dent in there. It's really hard to see because when I turn it, the dent moves. This is another one that reminds me sort of bubble bath. This is so refreshing. This is something completely inoffensive. I've heard Amy Glam talk about this quite often, and she talks about how she can wear it out anywhere. Everybody's going to love it. You're just going to smell good. You're just going to smell fresh and clean. I sprayed this on a sweatshirt once when we went out, and I folded the sweatshirt to put it away because it wasn't dirty. And a few months later, I took the sweatshirt out. I was actually decluttering my clothes, and I was like, I could smell this on it all those months later. I was like, oh my word, how beautiful is that? Very fresh, very crisp. Like, this is gorgeous. I absolutely love this one. This is perfect for especially working out, going on the treadmill, going to the gym. Yeah, perfect. Now here's one that is actually on the declutter chopping block, and this is Amazing Grace. I believe this is the EDT. I think I decluttered the EDP. This is a little bit too fresh and clean for me, if that's possible. I do like a little bit of a balance of woodiness and sweetness sometimes with my fresh and clean scents. This one is a little bit too much of a realistic bar of soap vibe to me. I feel like this would be good to layer with something, but I sometimes don't want to think that hard. I wore this on the treadmill one day and I didn't enjoy it. It felt too much like I had just forgotten to rinse all of the soap off of myself in the shower. Like, it just was a little bit annoying, a little bit too realistic soap-like. This is on the chopping block. I might play around with it a little bit longer, but it is maybe a possibility to be decluttered fairly soon. Calvin Klein Sheer Beauty is one of my best compliment getters. This is one that I can wear anywhere, easy reach. Everyone's going to compliment you. Everyone's going to love it. It has a sweetness to it. And to me, this is actually very unisex. I know it looks like kind of like a feminine girly bottle, but it actually is very unisex. I would love to smell this on my husband, actually. Now, this is one that I recommended. Someone had written to me wanting me to recommend them a wedding scent. They had quite a tight budget, so they were looking for something very affordable. They were looking for something that, like, I asked them what they liked for smells, and they didn't like, I can't remember, I think they didn't like citrus maybe, and they wanted a pretty bottle that would be in their wedding photos. So I recommended two. One was the Narciso Cristal, and the other one was Calvin Klein Sheer Beauty, and that is the one that they ended up going with. This has Peach Bellini, I think, in it. It's really pretty. It's sparkling and sweet and warm. Easy reach, love this one. Okay, Juliet Has a Gun, Not a Perfume. Well, this is the perfect skin scent. This is, to me, very woody in the best way. If you love woods, but you don't like it to smell like, you know, pencil shavings, you don't want it to smell like a smoky wood, but you want just a sexy, fresh, woody scent, this is it. It's almost ambery too, but not a sweet amber. Look at the sprayer on this, you guys. This is one that sometimes can be hard to smell on yourself because it is a molecular scent, and the size of the molecules maybe are a bit different than everybody's scent receptors in their nose, so that some people can really smell it very well and some can't. This was like my first niche perfume purchase ever. It really caught my attention out of dozens of samples I was testing. I was unimpressed by everything, but when I smelled this, I was like, oh my god, this is different. This is amazing. This is not sweet and You know, everything just seemed like it was just sweet. I tested all the designer perfumes. I would just describe them by saying, okay, it's sweet. This was indescribable to me. And I just posted a travel spray video, and I talked about how I have the Travel of Not a Perfume Superdose. And that is the one I would repurchase out of the two, because the Superdose is actually a lot easier to smell on yourself than this, because sometimes I'm even anosmic to this, although it does still get me compliments. I have three more here by Clean in their classic line. This is Clean White Woods. Gosh, I love this. I have a backup of it. It has a very sweet, sexy woods. I love this one. I don't feel like it would be a love for everybody because it is very musky. And people might think it smells like a cheap musk, but if it is a cheap musk, it's a sweet and sexy, clean white musk. If it's cheap, I don't care. I love it. Another one by Clean that I actually believe this one is discontinued, so I won't speak about it for too long, but it's called Warm Cashmere, and it is very, very, very similar to Byredo Baldafrique. So it has like a little bit of a lemony, grassy, pretty, woody, clean scent to it. Very cozy. I would wear this one for bedtime, and I have worn it for bedtime quite often. I actually have a dent down to about here where my thumbnail is. Absolutely love this one. Have you tried it? Did you ever wear this back in the day? Clean Warm Cashmere. And the last one by Clean that I have is Clean Blossom. And this actually does smell like an actual blossom on a tree. So if you've ever smelled blossoms in nature, they do have a little bit of soapiness to them. So if you smell a blossom on, say, a blackberry bush, if you smell an apple blossom, you're gonna get a little bit of a soapy smell. So this does have that soapiness to it. This was actually going to be decluttered, and I saved it from the declutter. I still need to play around with it and see what I think about it. Clean blossom, and it does smell like a realistic blossom to me. Okay, well, it's time to talk about one of the best of the best. This is Pure Musk by Narciso Rodriguez. Oh my goodness, this is the perfect soapy scent. It's got the most creamy, soapy, gorgeous musk. This is beautiful for bedtime. I can't imagine a more perfect bedtime scent than Narciso Rodriguez Pure Musk. Okay, so Fleur Missing Person, you guys. This was in my 9 perfumes I'm honored to own, and I still feel very honored to own this beautiful musk scent. It is probably my perfect skin scent that I could ever dream of. This is one of my favorites to wear to bed. I feel like this is one I would never be without. There's something so sexy about this that I just can't describe it. I don't know if it's a floral, I don't know if it's woods, I don't know if it's just the musk itself, but it is indescribably sexy. The perfect skin scent, it just makes me feel like I have found my perfect scent. That's how it makes me feel. This is very polarizing. There are people who really hate it. There are actually quite a few people who can't smell anything. They're completely anosmic to it. And that sometimes happens with skin scents, musky scents, but I'm one of the lucky ones that can smell this, and I'm so glad. Okay, Jovan White Musk. I'm not gonna say much about this. It's a white musk. It's kind of like Body Shop White Musk. It's a white musk. I don't know what to tell you. It's actually, sort of the same type of musk that is in the Clean White Woods I was talking about. I think people might think of this as a cheap drugstore musk, but it's a white musk, you know? It's just so good. If you don't like white musk, you're not gonna like it, but I love it. A couple more on the tray, and then I'll get to the ones along the side. This is Guess Dare. This is a very pillowy, thick musk. Actually, it has a little bit of a similar smell. Reminds me, puts me in mind of Hollister Wave, but with much more musk to it. Like, it's very thick, thick musk. It's such a thick musk, like a cloudy, pillowy musk, that I almost decluttered this. But I don't know, there's something so pretty about it. I'm not ready to let it go. So the last one on the tray is Lacoste Parfum. This is the original one. I also have the Legier, and I have Lacoste Parfum Elixir, and I have the Intense. This is your cozy, powdery hug in a bottle. Just a very light sweetness. It's as powdery as you can get, but it doesn't smell like baby powder, if that makes sense. It just smells like a beautiful warm hug. I've worn this before and I have caught whiffs of it and I thought, who smells that good? And it was me. Like, I absolutely love this one. Very powdery, perfect bedtime scent. Okay, another very powdery one is Violet Eyes by Elizabeth Taylor. And, you know, Elizabeth Taylor had violet eyes, but this doesn't have the note of violet in it, believe it or not. This is a beautiful powdery musk. This is one that when I spray this, like if I happen to spray it in the crook of my arm overnight and I wake up in the morning, the sexiness of the musk that is left behind on my inner elbow is just mind-blowing. I just almost cry. I'm like, oh my God, how could I smell so good? But I think this would be a little bit overwhelmingly powdery for people, but it, because of that powderiness, I still get that hug in a bottle feeling. I feel like this would give you a feeling like you're being mothered and like tucked into a cozy bed. I probably wouldn't wear this on like the treadmill or to work out because I feel it might be a little bit overwhelmingly powdery, but it's perfect for bedtime. And you could actually wear this out, you know, even grocery shopping, and I feel like you would, you know, have a great experience wearing this. And yet another purpley powdery scent, Bulgari Omnia Amethyst. This actually isn't too much different than Violet Eyes, but I find this one to be a little bit sweeter. Violet Eyes has almost a hint of herbalness in some parts of the experience, of the wearing experience in that one. But this one I find to be a little bit sweeter, a very pretty purpley sweetness, and it is intensely powdery. If you love powdery scents and you crave powdery scents and you don't mind them, I would highly recommend Bulgari Omnia Amethyst. So we have Lancome La Nuit Tresor Musc Diamant. Now this is a raspberry musk. This is a huge crowd pleaser, of one of my biggest compliment getters. The raspberry in here is not artificial in the least. It's almost like a fresh raspberry, but with a creamy musk. This is lovely, pretty, girly, feminine. I think it's discontinued, which is kind of sad because I feel like this is one of my easiest reach perfumes of all time. And I honestly, more than bedtime and more than, you know, treadmill or the gym, this is more for going out, going running errands, being around people, because I love to see how many compliments I can get off of this one. So Gap Homme is one of my perfect sandalwoods. I guess you could say it's kind of an artificial sandalwood, but it would be kind of the perfect mix between something like Elizabeth and James Nirvana Black and a more realistic sandalwood like, let's say, Santal 33. This would be kind of in between those two. This does have like almost a, I feel like it has a type of sweetness in it that could almost be nauseating to some people, if you know what I mean. It does almost have a bit of an artificial smell to it, but in a good way, if that makes sense at all. This is the newer reformulation, but I actually have a sample of the original Gap Homme, and it is very, it puts you in a very zen state of mind. I like to wear this one to bed. And last but not least, don't make fun of me. This is Ariana Grande Moonlight. This was my bedtime scent for the longest time. This one is probably the most generically sweet of all of the ones on this tray. And this is like kind of, it kind of reminds me of a marshmallow. I absolutely love the purple pom-pom on this too. I love it. I don't know. Am I crazy? I just absolutely love it. That should probably be dusted too. Is there any dust coming off of that? Anyway, I actually have a backup of this, although I don't think I'm going to need it. This is 100 ml and it's gigantic. I have so many perfumes, I don't go through them that fast. But Ariana Grande Moonlight is, if you want something a little bit sweeter for bedtime, I would recommend this. And that's the only time I really use it, is for bedtime. I don't, yeah, that's the only use I really have for this one. So I'm going to clean up my tray, you guys. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. Thanks for watching me clean up my fresh and clean tray. What do you guys like to wear to bed? What do you like to wear to the gym? Do you have a category like this? Or do you just avoid that category of fragrance altogether? Thank you guys so much for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.